bike is fun and exciting, especially in a place that's different.
This is a map of South America.
The red line is where we went. We started at the bottom in Chile and we finished at the top in Bolivia. There are many differences along. This is my family and I on our first week of biking. It was really hard because we hadn't been biking like this before. We were biking all day and we would only stop for a short period of time. Each night we stayed in our tent. The first lesson I learned is that when you're on the bike, you can sense everything around you. You can see the birds above, hear the trees rustling, smell the flowers, and feel the wind on your face. And you have to get out of the way when there's a herd of cows coming. Traveling by bike is a slow way to travel. For example, you see something up ahead and then it comes closer and closer. But in a car, you see something up ahead and then it's already behind you. We were excited to see our first huancos, which are like wild llamas. Out on the pampa, or plains, we came across a family of lecerillas, which are like small ostriches. These experiences were new and exciting. The weather is always changing, which means that sometimes we have to stop and set up camp. We lived in our tent for 8 months. This means falling asleep to sounds of nature. Some nights were cold and others hot. On the bike, people were really interested in us. We usually couldn't get through a town without my mom and dad chatting with locals. We met many people, some on bikes, some driving horse and wagons, and many in cars. The people were friendly and helpful. Being outside gives you the opportunity for special moments. In this campsite in the woods, we saw this pygmy owl when we were collecting sticks for firewood. We looked at it for about 10 minutes, and it looked at us. The second lesson I learned is that when you're on the bike, there's quiet time, and that makes... On the bike, we didn't have a phone or music. We didn't have lots of things to do each day, like music lessons, birthday parties, or school. We had lots of free time to play or be by ourselves and make things. We only brought a couple of toys, so we had to be creative and make them into many different things. In this quiet time, our play was very similar to what we saw on the bike. This day, we were riding through road construction, and after making a mound with my sister's Hello Kitty set, a toy wagon, and a bike tool we brought. This wasn't boring, it was a happy atmosphere. In the darkness, it was so quiet that you could let your mind wander. Depending on the campsite, you could hear the crickets or the grass swaying, or the occasional car pass on the road. Then, each morning, the old place looked brand new. We had lots of time to get up and ready at our own pace. I love camping. The quietest place we visited was the salt flats in Bolivia. It was kind of lonely because you couldn't see anybody for miles and miles. In this kind of place, you feel small and the world feels big around you. The third lesson I learned is that when you do something hard, you feel great at the end. During the end of our trip, we had to climb a very high pass. This was the first pass that I rode all the way up on my own. It wasn't easy. The start was hard because we didn't have a rhythm. To get up, we would ride for a while, rest for a short time, and then keep going. There are surprises too, like the snowman that our friends left for us. It took a lot of effort because sometimes I was tired and just wanted to stay there. But we couldn't stay there because there wasn't any flat ground to set up our tent. So we had to go all the way up to the top of the pass down to a place with water. At the top, we felt really good to have made it up all this way. This was over 2 years ago, and I still feel proud of myself. Remembering this helps me get through other challenging things at home, like music practice or hard things at school. I would like to finish with a video of me biking up the pass.
The quiet time on the bike gives me time to think, not just one thought, but many. When we're quiet, we hear and see lots of things. I like the cactuses, plants, the birds, and just being out here. I like it.